All right, so that brings us to the last activity of this set. And here we have a company that has issued two kinds of stock at once. 10,000 shares of common that had a $10 par value, and 5,000 shares of preferred stock that had a $5 par value, and it's one big lump sum, $900,000 in total is the cash that we got. The market values of the common stock and preferred stock were $80 and $40 respectively. Okay, so we have two different classes of stock, common and preferred. We issued some of each for one lump sum, and here we've got information about the fair values were 80 and 40. Now that's a per share basis. Okay, so number one says, this, rightly so, is the third chapter where we've had to deal with a lump sum of cash being split between two or more items. So in chapter 10, we looked at paying one amount for multiple assets. In chapter 14, we looked at those issuing convertible debt under IFRS. Okay, and we talked about the fact that if we got a lump sum, we'd have to split it. So see, just if you remember what that approach is called, we should use to split the $900,000 between common and preferred stock. Okay, so thinking. Hopefully, at this point in the semester, you're like, I know it was that thing where you add up the values and take the percentages, and you're right. It's called the relative fair value approach. And now if you didn't remember it, you're like, oh, okay, now I remember that thing where you add up the fair values and then use them as a percentage. Okay, so then just to get you set to do the relative fair value approach, question two says, what is the market value of the total common stock issued? I issued 10,000 shares. And the market value for the common was $80 a share. So if you do that math, $80 times 10,000 shares, that's going to give you $800,000. That's the fair value of the share of the common shares. Okay, or the market value. And then question three says, what's the market value of the total preferred stock? Okay, so it's not just asking for a per share basis. We're asking for the total, which is critical in both of these. Okay, so we have 5,000 shares of preferred at $40. So we do the exact same thing. 40 times 5,000 shares is going to give me 200,000. That's the market value. Okay, so now you remember how to use the relative fair value approach. I'll give you a real quick rundown. You're going to take the fair values of each. Market value, you know, means the same thing as fair value. And you'd say, here's common and preferred. 800,000, 200,000. I add those together and I get 1,000,000. And then I say, what percentage of 1,000,000 is 800,000? This is easy math, okay? If it was, you know, more complicated, you'd take 800 divided by 1,000,000 and you get 80%. 200 divided by 1,000,000, you get 20%. Once you have those values, you remember you multiply them by that original lump sum. So let's do that down here at the bottom, or right here. You can do it here on the side. Okay, so if I take 80% times 900,000, that is going to give me 720,000. Okay, and that is my common. And then my preferred, 20% times 900,000. Of course, you know, I could just subtract and get the amount, but showing how we got there. Okay, that's 180,000. So that is the total amount of cash I received from issuing these common shares, and this is the total amount of cash I received from issuing the preferred shares. So the very last thing we do is we're going to record this, and what we need to keep in mind now to do the recording are those par values. So we had a $10 par for the common and a $5 par for the preferred. So I'm going to do the entry down here at the bottom. We know we got cash of $900,000, right? That was given in the problem. Okay, we know we got common. And I ask you to keep two separate PIC accounts. So we have a PIC for common stock. And we have a preferred stock. Going to have a separate additional PIC for preferred. All right. Now we just, it's a matter of putting in the par values. So the common stock was $10 par, and it was 10,000 shares, so that would be 100,000 here. And I know I had 720 in total for the common, so that must mean that the remaining 620 is going to additional paid-in capital for the common. The preferred had a $5 par value, $5 for 5,000 shares, so that was 25,000. And I know I had 180 for my total here, so this is 155. Right. Just to see where my numbers came from. Alrighty, that's that. That's the end. Probably some questions. Just to reinforce, here's the very common mistake people make, so I'll point it out to you. Okay, if you just take the market values of the shares, you would have gotten the wrong percentages. Okay, we're going to look at the total market value when we're considering the relative fair value approach, right? Different weights because we didn't issue the same number of common and same and preferred shares. All right, then there's just some questions to make sure you got the right answers. And that is it. So that takes care of this set of activities.